Previously on the Jethroverse.
Well, you may have gotten word about a timeline disturbance. Two of my guys are supposed to handle it, but not sure how much we're gonna get out of them.
There must be something we can do.
What are you thinking?
I'm not exactly sure, but I do know that there are two men that might have the key to what we need.
Someone's here to see us, Wayne.
Who is it?
It's Vincent Cayde, one of those randos who changed the timeline.
How about you let that bastard in? We got a lot to talk about.
It isn't Vincent Cayde.
Yeah, and Claire Martin.
You've been expecting us?
Oh, we just saw that you were coming.
Ah, to an uninformed ear, that would sound like you're talking about ejaculation. You know, how do you know about us anyway? We've been retired for over a year, buddy.
Kinda, at least.
Nah, but you shut up.
I don't know if you remember, but we met a couple years ago.
Oh, I think he's saying we're a couple of geezers.
Well, you respect your elders, twerp.
What I meant is that you guys used to work with the Parliament, and I found your names turn up a couple times.
Do they remember us fondly?
Yeah, what he means is, are they still, like, pissed off at us?
Honestly, I have no idea what they think of you, because in this timeline, they've collapsed.
Yeah.
Suppose you come here to ask us how to change the timeline back.
No.
What?
All right, Vincent, you sack of bricks. You don't understand that.
So what exactly is it that you need from us, Cayde and Ms. Martin?
I want to keep this timeline intact.
Oh, you think this is better somehow?
His brother's alive. The whole reason he screwed up the timeline was because his brother died.
Yeah, which happens. Brothers die. No need to be a bitch about it.
Yeah, you're being unbelievably stupid.
You know that, right?
Look. I know that other people's lives were affected more than mine, worse than mine, but I need to know if there's at least a glimmer of hope.
We want to help you, Vincent, but it's hard balancing the negative and positive repercussions of all this.
Well, luckily, we have someone to, consult on matters such as these.
Are you kidding me right now?
Did we, interrupt you again, boss?
I was in the middle of brokering a peace with the Zendavians on Earth 36. Do you have any idea how important that is?
Not me. I've tried to stay out of their way.
Oh, the Zendavians are a, fierce bunch.
Wait. I know the Zendavians.
And who the hell are you?
I'm Vincent Cayde. My brother and I once saved a Zendavian princess. I think her name was Macarena? Well, if you find her, tell her that Vincent Riker say hello. That'll score you some points.
Good lord, he's some kind of intergalactic man whore.
Stuff it, Wayne.
Alright, Cayde. Let's see if you have any, credibility. One second. Here we go.
That's your boss?
The superintendent? Yes.
Like, they've been a little, tightly wound since they, you know, they got promoted, demoted, promoted again, and they're worried they'll just, you know, just make a little, horrible screw-up like they did last time.
Will they be back?
Woo, that was quick.
This office is isolated from the time stream, in case you forgot. I've been gone 5 days. Worked like a charm. Minnie Kranna convinced her father to sign the peace treaty. we created. King Zatmoach from the province Blasignal introduced me to his son afterwards. We became good friends. His name is Aaron, or should I say Aaron?
Okay, are these like proper nouns, or are you having a stroke?
Thanks for the tip.
Anytime.
Superintendent, we got a problem.
Of course, because no one ever calls me to just hang. Which is...
Well, this idiot changed the timeline, and he's looking for us to find a way for it to be preserved.
Ow!
Do you have any idea how stupid that was? Changing the entire timeline? Why the hell would you do that?
Because his brother died!
I can empathize.
Here we go again.
Are they okay?
The superintendent has an encyclopedic memory of every event that has ever happened in the multiverse and in every timeline.
Then why didn't they know about Riker?
Well, they have to access the information that she wants, voiced. That's what they're doing right now.
Well, we are all royally screwed. Yep. Yeah.
Oh, yeah? Why is that?
Long story short, there's no way to salvage this timeline. But, however, there is something I can do.
Good?
Right before he died, Geoffrey Jackson whispered something in Jethro Smith's ear. He did that in this timeline as well. Except, Jethro died shortly after.
What did he say?
We don't know. That's the thing. But, we do know how Jethro learned about it.
Well, how did he learn about it?
I'm so glad you asked.
Do you need anything else, Geoffrey?
No, I'm good. Thanks for everything you've done, though.
Geoffrey, are you sure that you're okay? 'Cause yesterday you took a pretty nasty fall.
Hell yeah, I did. Remember all the blood?
Yeah, you were bleeding like Kerry White.
Who?
Never mind.
But seriously, thanks for taking care of me while my parents are away. I really appreciate it. This thing's killing me. I don't know what I would have done if you weren't here.
Of course I take care of you. We've been friends for, I don't know, 5-6 years now? Ever since you were the little piece of shit that I had to take care of in Book Buddies. But you know, you've grown since then, and I mean, so have I. Mostly because of you. You've helped me grow and, you know, not really just think about myself. Well, not as much anyway. But I care about you like someone cares about their little brother. Like, I don't know what would happen if something even more than this happened to you. I wouldn't know how to feel, how to react. So I really care about you, Geoffrey. Okay, I gotta go take a shit.
Who the hell are you?
I'm Jethro. Jethro Smith.
Didn't you just go take a shit?
No, I'm not that Jethro Smith. I'm Jethro Smith from the future. I don't expect you to understand. Hell, I barely understand it myself. But I need to tell you something very important. Something that you're gonna have to tell him. But not when he comes out of the bathroom. There will be a time when you have to tell him this. And it's very important because lives are hanging in the balance. You have to tell him this. I have to go. I've already been here too long. Ooh, ah, that felt nice. Anything happen while I was gone?
So, a version of Jethro from the future told Geoffrey to say something to Jethro?
In layman's terms, yes.
Who's layman, and why is this important?
I don't know if it is, but it could be. You asked.
Yeah, I guess I did.
Mm-hmm. How would we find out what Geoffrey said if he's dead and we can't interact with Jethro?
Johan!
Who?
He's Jethro's best friend. Jethro might have told him something about what Geoffrey said.
There you go.
All right, so they gave you what you needed.
Well, we don't know if it's what we needed.
Well, it's a lead. You might as well follow it.
I guess so. Shall we go?
We shall.
Hey, thanks.
Felicia.
Where are we?
We're outside Jeffrey's house, right after he died. Hey, Johan.
Who are you?
We're from the future, and we're trying to fix this timeline so it doesn't completely collapse.
There's a fucking surprise.
Jethro's going to come out of that house in a minute. You need to ask him what Geoffrey said to him.
Okay.
Trust me, this could be incredibly important. It could save the Jethroverse.
Jethroverse!
Bro, what the hell's the Jethroverse?
Hey, you okay, man? No, I'm not okay. Jeffrey's dead! He's dead!
What did he say to you?
How are you even semi-calm about this? Jeffrey's dead. An 11-year-old boy, an 11-year-old kid that we called our friend, just died.
What did he say?
I didn't hear him, okay? I'm sorry that I'm distracted by his dying breaths.
Jethro, you know I can tell when you lie.
How can you be so fucking calm?
Jethro, I'm the opposite of calm. Our friend is dead. How often does that happen?
Well, on the outside, you're as cool as a cucumber.
What does that mean?
Well, what do you expect me to say when I'm freaking out over one of my best friends being shot? He was 11, Johan. He was 11.
So, nice weather we're having. Yeah,
it's really, yeah.
Cool, totally normal people. Mm-hmm. Not
yeah, this is our car. Well?
Well, Geoffrey told him something. I think he lied about it, but I don't know what it was.
Damn it! Are you sure we can't just go talk to Jethro?
We cannot risk the timeline. I'm sorry, Vincent.
Wait, what's going on here? Who are you people?
Thank you for your service.
Could this day get any weirder?
Boss, just a question. Why didn't you know what Geoffrey Jackson said to Jethro Smith? Should be able to know that.
I do know that. And even if they do find out what Geoffrey said to Jethro, it doesn't matter. It's completely out of relevance!
Then why did you tell him to follow the lead?
Well, that was you. Technically, you did. But, honestly, I just wanted them out of this office.
But why?
This timeline is not salvageable. I hope Vincent Cayde figures that out and resets it. If it continues to exist, the consequences could be disastrous.
Vincent Cayde and Claire Martin, where are they?
Who?
Oh, I must have missed them by a few minutes.
Oh yeah, Vincent. That's the guy that was here with the girl, right?
Yes. Where did they go?
They just poofed.
Poofed?
They had, like, a watch or something.
Oh, you've got to be kidding me. Another dead end.
Excuse me? Am I just some kind of dead end to you?
Shh. I'm heading back to base.
Oh, cool. You have one of those watches, too.
Thank you for your service.
That was a bust.
Unfortunately.
You know what?
What?
I think the superintendent led us on a wild goose chase.
Unfortunately, I think you might be right.
Yeah.
So where do we go from here?
I have no idea. I was hoping we could rely on Drake and Wayne for leads.
And they clearly didn't deliver. Vincent, maybe you have to accept that we can't keep this timeline. It doesn't seem like it has any redeemable qualities.
I know what to do.
You do?
We have to find Ellie.
Ah, Ellie.
My ex-girlfriend.
I know who she is.
You do? How?
I've met her.
Really? In the future?
Maybe.
Maybe?
Just let it go. Let's find Ellie Martin.
This is most assuredly incorrect.
What is it this time, Wayne?
Well, apparently Vincent Cayde and Claire Martin weren't the only ones who came into this timeline from the other one. Someone followed them.
Well, I wonder who it could have been.